Hey there and welcome. My name is Mr. Barry, and today we're going to be looking at the Frunk, or the front trunk, of a Tesla Model 3. So I'm going to be actually showing you how to remove the Frunk insert and show you some of the bits that are actually underneath there. And then I'm going to show you how to put it all back together there. Alrighty, so let's take a look at that, you and I. Come on. So the first step in getting into the Frunk and all that is, of course, to open it. So there you go. So here's inside what the inside of the Frunk looks like. And this is what the outside looks like. Now this is a 2020 Model 3 long range with dual motor. Here's a quick disclaimer. If you are actually preparing to work on your car today, you'll need to power off the car by pressing the car icon on the screen, then go to Safety and Security Settings. Then tap Power Off. Now go to the rear seat on the passenger side and release the two clips that are holding the rear seat down. Those are located in the front at the bottom of the rear seats. When you lift it up, you'll see a styrofoam cover and this switch, which is located underneath that styrofoam cover. Flip the switch down, you'll hear a bang, and now the car is officially off. And keep this door open so you can reach in and turn on the power again. Do not close or open any doors at this time because the doors need power to lower or raise their windows when closing or opening. So don't close this door. And please click on thumbs up as that really helps the video and the channel. All right, first thing you want to do is remove the mat. Move the tow hook. All right. Now this part right here, we're going to take this off first. And this is, you pry it up there. And then you have to remove this cable. You can do that with a small flathead screwdriver. Now this only goes in one way, so when you're putting it back, just be aware that there's three little holes there for your electrical contacts, and inside of this there are also three. So just make sure that you line that up when you're putting everything back together. So to take this cover off, you reach behind it, pulling up and towards you, and you can feel it snapping there as it were unsnapping. There we go. You can see the attachment points there. Now once you have that top cover removed, you notice that you have access to the 12 volt battery as well as the brake fluid. If you ever need to replace that 12 volt battery, you'll need to remove the air intake shroud, which I'll be showing here in a few moments. And then you'll have full access to that 12 volt battery. Okay, we're now going to remove the seven 10 millimeter bolts that you see here. They're all identical, so you don't need to remember which bolts went into which holes. Thank you.
After removing those 7 bolts, what we're going to do is remove this part right here, this part of the air intake for the passenger compartment. So we're just going to pull up on these. So we're just pulling up, and there we go. Now we have access to the 12 volt battery if I needed to replace that. All right, now all this Frunk insert, it's all one piece. So I'm going to take it out. There are clips here, here, here in the front, here, here, here. So you're going to be pulling up and towards you. Now once it's all out here, just carry it out carefully. So now that the Frunk insert is removed, let's take a look inside, shall we?
This is the dual motor, meaning there's a motor for the rear axle and a motor for the front axle. Here we see the brake fluid reservoir as well as the windshield wiper reservoir. Tesla's Superbottle combines what would be two coolant overflow bottles, one for the motor and one for the traction battery in other EVs, into a single bottle. Plus, it integrates the electric coolant pumps for each coolant loop into the bottle itself, in addition to the coolant flow valve that directs the coolant's flow. And this is the passenger's compartment AC system. Now, this block of metal is called the chiller. The chiller is a heat exchanger between the refrigerant and the coolant. It pulls out more heat from the coolant than just ambient airflow through a radiator could. Tesla designed the Model 3's electric power steering system to have a rapid 10-to-1 ratio. The power steering is equipped with a full redundancy with separate power feeds taken directly from the vehicle's high voltage battery. The engineers also mentioned two electronic modules and two inverters providing hot backup to the systems if one fails. Here we see the front motor of this dual motor Tesla. Now, dual motor Model 3s use a combination of a permanent magnet motor at the back and a traditional induction motor in the front. In this way, they are both quick off the line and more efficient at highway speeds.
Okay, well, let's go ahead and just put everything back together, and we'll just put it together in the same way as it was removed. So the very first thing is the Frunk insert. So this is drops in. Be careful that you get everything lined up. There is a cable, by the way, down in the front of the front. You want to make sure that you have access to that. Okay. All right. Now, as far as the clips, you want to make sure that you get the clips right in to the places where they should be.
Now install the interior airflow vent cover. We do this by lining up the hose and then pressing them straight down firmly.
Okay, now we're going to put in the 10 millimeter bolts back into place. Now what we need to do is to attach the front cover here for this latch mechanism. And so you want to make sure that you again align this in the proper orientation into the plug. And we'll put that back together. There you go, just snaps right in. This, you want to make sure that you don't crimp the wires. So carefully put that in there, and then this gets pressed down and in. There it is. Okay, now we're going to be putting on this cover and just line up. And pop them in place. And you don't want to be without your tow hook. It goes right there. Reinstall the mat. And you're done. Now to close the frunk, what you need to do is bring it down. And once it's down, using both hands on either side of the Tesla mark, it's done. All right.
Hey, there you go. Now you know what's underneath the frunk of a Tesla Model 3. You know what all the little bits do and why they're there. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below because I love to read your comments, and share the video. By the way, if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. And I just wanted to say thank you for all the wonderful comments that everyone's been leaving. And I know this video is a little bit different. Normally I do about computer systems, but hey, a Tesla is kind of like a computer on wheels, right? So hopefully you enjoyed it. I know I really enjoyed making the video for you. So, hey, thank you again and bye-bye.